and all of these things that you have a sound of, it all is because of the Word of God. Ooh, hallelujah. I got to find me a crowd that understands what I'm trying to say here. Here's what he says in St. John 10:27. They're mine, and it's no enemy that they have that's going to overcome them. This is Jesus' attitude. Look at St. John 10:27 in the world, please. St. John 10:27. My sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and they follow me. I give unto them eternal life, and they should never perish. Neither should any what? Man do what? Pluck them out of my hand. They're mine. There's not an enemy that they got that's going to take them from me. Now we've got to realize we've got enemies out here. In the winter season, fall season, call the flu. In the economic seasons, call the recession, depression, and stress. It says that Paul says, I've learned in every state that I'm in to be content. I know how to be abased and I know how to abound. Every situation, I know that the shepherd's got me covered. Sure. I remember Pastor here talking about the Psalms 23, how the snakes, it's in the pit. And they come up out of the pit, and every time the snake walks by, well, the shepherd will have this little deal on his shoulder, and he'll pull it into another snake hole. And every time the snake come up, just to bite, he slips back down. And the sheep is just following along. See, sheep don't know what, they get lost, so they just follow him along. And the good shepherd, he goes along pouring his oil into the hole that the snakes are coming up out of. So that the sheep don't get bit. The sheep has no idea the shepherd's already taken care of. Here's my enemies coming up. One of my favorite things in scripture, Psalms 27. I bet more than two or three of us can't quote that. Cool, we don't even well, Psalms, ooh. The Lord is my what? Psalms 27. The Lord is my what? And my salvation. Whom shall I do what? I'm going to Cancun because they're killing each other down there. What shall I do what? What shall I be afraid of? Now, that's not in my head, that's in my what? What should I be afraid of? When my enemies and my foes do what? Come up against me, they what? They eat up my flesh. Become my enemies. Job loss. Recession. Sickness. Ready to take me out. When all those enemies, any one of them, come up against me, and that's what David said. They come up against what? Me. You got to make it personal. They stumble and they fall. Though a host encamp round about me, even in this will I be what? Confident. Glory to God. Well, strike up the music, let's do. Even in this will I be what? Confident. One thing have I desired of the Lord. And that's what's called the Word. It's no more, it's real to me, it's real to you, but it's really real when you hear yourself say, what shall I be afraid of? Glory to God. Because the shepherd is saying that, I'm here for you. I got you. No enemy, nothing is going to pluck them out of my care. That's what Jesus, he says, oh no, you're not getting to them. You're there, you're real, sickness is real, financial is real, all that's real, but you're not giving to them. Hallelujah. St. John 10:27, my sheep hear my voice, I know them, and they follow me. I give unto them eternal life, they should never perish, neither should any man pluck them out of my hand. My Father which gave them me is greater than all, and no man is able to pluck them out of my hand. Nobody is able to hurt them when I got them. Soon as you buy that plan, you're on your way. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Well, someone said praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
So, here as I want to bring to a conclusion, is as his our protection. Our protection is the Word of God. The enemy, that's the last thing he wants you to access, is the Word of God. It's the last thing he wants you to really digest and sell out to, is the Word of God. He wants you to hear all the other sounds and partake and buy into those plans. But the Word of God, he does not want you to have access to. He'll give you all type of stumbling blocks on Wednesday evening. Sunday morning, that pillow sure feels good about 9:30. Somehow or another, the sheets got cooler. You snuggle up. You make plans to read your Bible at nighttime, maybe 9:30, 10 o'clock, and you read for about 2 minutes, and then you have the best sleep of your life.
All right.
Glory to God. Take the Bible to work and put it on your desk, and maybe your boss says, take that down, throw it in the drawer. Something always gets in the way of what? Reading and digesting. He told Joshua, what chapter was that? Is that the 8th chapter of Joshua? This book of the law should not depart out of your mouth, but meditate in it. How often?
Day and night.
So that you can make your way what? You can make your way very successful. And whatever you put your hands to do, it shall prosper. Hallelujah. The government sold us a bill of goods. We don't believe that. We're going to read the Tulsa World. Jobs, employment, unemployment, 9-10%. Obama, somebody in this and that, the White House, and the economist, and this and that, and jobs, and unemployment checks, and welfare, and Social Security, and Medicaid, Medicare, everybody looking for it, fighting for it. The prescription's right in front of us on the shelf. All we got to do is dust it off. This book of the law, should you meditate day and night, and you should find good success. Okay, that's good. What about my being, my total, my man? Can I be alive? Can I be vital? Proverbs 4:20. My son, it says, listen to my words. Incline your ear to my sayings. For they are life and healing to all of your flesh. Is that what it says somewhere? If you haven't, read it out loud for me. Keep me from turning to it. Anybody got it? Proverbs 4:20.
My son, attend to my words. Incline thy ear unto my sayings. Let them not depart from thine eyes. Keep them in the midst of thine heart. For they are life unto those that find them, and health to all their flesh.
I have great respect for the medical profession, but they're not a health to my flesh. What? Williams, are you crazy? No. I don't take a regimen of, I'm 58 years old, I don't take a regimen of nothing. Pills, this, high blood, low blood, sugar, that, I don't know. My son, attend to my what?
Words.
Incline your ear to my what?
Sayings.
Now, you know, we just read that and something went in here that still don't buy it. Holy Ghost gave me a check. Say it again, because they didn't bought into it. My son, attend to my what?
Words.
Incline your ear to my sayings. And that saying is hitting you in your heart, man. He's saying, are you going to listen to what the word is saying? So what's in the word? How to live, how to eat, how to rest, how to do everything. Come that you might have life, and have life what? More abundantly. Then come for you to be stressed out. It didn't come for you to be poor.